Dear students, today we will learn how to factorize any expression, whether we need to use identity in it or not. This method is applicable on each and every question, and this method is known as splitting the middle term. Let us see how to do. In the very first question, it is given x square plus 7x plus 12. Now, let us see how to solve this problem. See, here this constant is 12. Whatsoever is the coefficient of x and this 12, they are need to be multiplied. So, if we multiply 1 and 12, we get 1 into 12 is equal to 12. Okay. Now, we have to split this 7 in a manner that the product of the sum is 12 and the sum is 7. The product is 12 and sum is 7. So, we need to split it in that manner. See, when you factorize 12, you get its factor as 3 and 4. 3 fours are 12 and 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. So, we are successful in finding factors of 12 whose sum is 7 and product is 12. Okay, so we will factorize 7x as x square plus 4x plus 3x plus 12. See, we are able to factorize 7x such that the sum is 4 plus 3, 7x, and product is 4 threes are 12x square. The product of first term and product of last term. I repeat, product of first term and product of last term. If you multiply 12 and x square, you will get 12x square. And if you multiply 4x and 3x, you will get 12x square. And when you add 4x and 3x, you get 7x. So, we have splitted the middle term in a manner that the product of the two terms is equal to the product of its extremes. These are the extreme terms. So, product of these two terms is equal to the product of extremes. Now, in these two terms, what is common? X, what is left? When you take out 1x from x square, x will be left plus. When you take out x from here, what will be left? 4 plus. Out of these two terms, what is common? 3. Take out 3 common. What will be left? X plus. When you divide 12 by 3, you get 4, x plus 4. Now, you can see in this expression, x plus 4 is common in both the terms. So, take out x plus 4 as common. What is left? X plus 3. This is your answer. I repeat the method. First of all, what we do, we find the product of extreme, which is 12 x square, but we need not to consider the variable term. We only consider the numerical coefficient, that is 12. Now, we need to factorize 12 in a manner such that the product of the factors is 12 and sum of the factors is 7, the middle term. Okay, so we find that 12 can be factorized as 3 and 4, which is equal to 12. And the sum is equal to 7. So, we split the middle term in a manner such that we obtain x square plus 4x plus 3x plus 12. Out of these two terms, we find that here x is common. We take out x as common. What is left? X plus 4. Here 3 is common. What is left? X plus 4. Always remember, we will obtain the same term in the bracket. If you are not obtaining the same term within the bracket, that means you have committed some error. So, you have to take care of that. So, x plus 4 is common in both the terms. We take up x plus 4 as common. What is left? X plus 3. This is the required answer.